Hello, I'm Nobody, and this is my view, sent to The View, and especially Miss Woopi Goldberg, who asked why everyone's so angry. I can't speak for everyone because I am not everyone. In fact, I'm nobody. In fact, I'm your typical nobody, probably. When it comes to your typical nobody who understands what Trump's saying and who understands why the people support Trump the way they do. When it comes to understanding that Hillary Clinton is full of it, as much as I'm a woman and I would like to support her, I can't. And I'm almost ashamed to call myself a woman or an American or anything like that at this point, including a minister who was ordained and licensed by a world church I've denounced since. I am your typical nobody who understands all too well the anger in America and the outrage that we are seeing, the protests that we are seeing, the outbursts that we are seeing, the extremes that we are seeing, and who understands Trump's popularity, Bernie Sanders' popularity, I don't know, maybe I can give you some insight or my view on it all. Of course, my view means nothing because, as I said, I'm a nobody, and I'm sure my view will be highly censored because it is what it is. But Americans are outraged about the, continuation of, complete systematic abuse by a very corrupt system that was sold and marketed to the people as freedom to protect them and their protection, but has only ended up protecting the corporation that enslaved them through the contract of the Constitution. Of course, most Americans don't even understand this because most Americans don't even begin to understand the Constitution and their constitutional rights, though they do understand that they're enraged and outraged because their rights are being violated every day as cops kick in their doors and violate their rights and their families and their privacy and their supposed protection. While systematically abusing the system to accomplish whatever goal or task they believe that they're there to accomplish. Most of the time, no one knows what's going on, the victim who's being violated and the cop that's doing it, because they're all just following orders. Americans are angry because the right to vote's taken before they even understand what the right to vote is or how important the right to vote is or even how the vote works. And a lot of Americans are angry just because even though they were educated in our public school system, they never had the Electoral College explained to them enough so that they even understand how the voting system works, or that it's actually by how they register to vote that dictates the Electoral College or how a president is elected. Americans are angry because when they are robbed or raped or victimized in a brutal assault or an attempted murder, and they do call police, usually that is followed by them being raped by police, or beaten by police, or assaulted by police. At least in my own personal experience on several different occasions. Americans are angry because there is no justice in our justice system when they try to seek justice against their attackers or those that are violent against them, and their attacker spends one night in jail so he can come back out and beat her again the next day, or their attacker comes back out so he can somehow get his name on her mortgage so that he can now stalk her for the rest of her life. Americans are angry because when they do get court orders explaining that their stalkers do not live in their homes, and that their stalkers need to turn their homes over to them, the court order is ignored, the court order disappears, it's hidden in the fourth floor filing cabinet at the courthouse, cops don't acknowledge it, law enforcement don't enforce it, and they're forced to live for years with abusive stalkers that are trying to kill them, and everyone ignores it because it's socially acceptable because they got their name. Americans are angry because of the stacks and stacks of legal cases that are being brought against them every day in the courtroom, in the filing boxes they have full of them, when they can't get justice against the people that are attacking them or stalking them. But every company and corporation that wants to file a lawsuit, or every individual that claims, files a case against them, they have to spend years in court proving their innocence. Americans are angry because while they're fighting all these legal cases and they're trying to stay self-sufficient and pay their mortgage and pay their bills, they keep losing their jobs because they have to piss in cups because you can't smoke a joint in this country and you're only allowed to take as many prescription drugs as you want to take. But some people don't like addiction and they don't want to do prescription drugs, and therefore, well, screw you because you're a naturopath and we're against farmers and there's a war on nature and there's a war on people and it's all about the corporation and corporate farming and big pharma and big business and big government, big corporate government, big corporate world churches. Oh, and did I mention Americans are angry because the church wants to keep lying to them and dividing them and pitting them against each other on their religion, when in fact, you know, some of the major churches, including the Jewish church, the Catholic church, three major religions, all came from Moses, who wrote the first five books of the Bible and the Torah. And titles, like titles of ministry and license from different states, and certifications saying you know and saying you've spent years studying and all that really mean nothing today, especially when you have to have a college, you know, 1 year of college or whatever to work at McDonald's. Well, talk about devaluing all those thousands of dollars you spent to get your degree or your certificate. It goes right out the window. And, you know, I mean, we could go on and on and on about what Americans are angry about. I could make a series out of it and have my own talk show. Like the fact that even though we raised minimum wage, some states disagree with that, and so the state won't implement that minimum wage increase. So therefore, some people are getting minimum wage while other people are not, depending on what state you live in. And how, by any means, does raising minimum wage fix anything, as it drives prices on up on everything through the roof? And we can cap the farmer and cap tobacco prices and cap soybean prices and cap this and that, and we can sell them GMO seed and make them buy our, you know, this corporate seed or that corporate seed, so that, you know, a certain 1% or group of people get all the money all the time. You know, the same ones that lobby our congressmen and, you know, elect our president. They're just angry because we can cap the farmer, but we can't cap the pharmacist. We can cap the farmer, but we won't cap the doctor. You know, the majority of the doctors that want to lie to us and sell us this addictive medicine that's never going to cure or fix anything, because we can't even fix the common cold, while we claim that we're the only way, and we mandate it to everyone through an unconstitutional Obamacare. Americans are angry because we know how to repeal Obamacare, but we don't know how to repeal prohibition of cannabis and put it back into our gardens. Or we don't know how to repeal genetically modified seed and keep corporations out of our gardens and out of our homes. Americans are angry because Congress was only given the authority to police currency in the marketplace in foreign war, but somehow they've made it into our bedrooms and our families through an abuse of power. So, I cannot speak for everyone, but I speak for at least me. And I had my say. And it may not be all I have to say, because like I said, that would be a mini-series. Or it just may go on and on and on into a never-ending morning show. But that will never happen because I'm nobody. In Kentucky. Bowling Green, Kentucky. And you ladies have a good day. And everyone out there, I'm praying for this country. I'm praying for the globe. Time to smell the flowers and enjoy your loved ones if they're still there to enjoy, and peace out.